Hello, my beautiful friendlies. Today, we are going to be learning how to do custom crafting on the floor. This is known as floor crafting, where you throw two items together and it creates a new item. Now, we're going to be using command blocks to do this. So, this is called I Can Do That. This is a show where you guys can spice up your world with simple things that you guys should try to improve your command block knowledge. If you don't know how to use commands, I do that little ding sound every time. It's linking you to the tutorials page, which is in the description. Now, I advise that you guys look at that page so you can find this a lot easier, because some of the concepts, I'm trying to cover everything I can, but some of these things I won't be able to cover. So if you get confused at any point, I highly suggest you look at the tutorials page there. So first off, we need to give ourselves a command block. We need to make this a repeating command block, so it activates 20 times per second, and it must be always active. So, what are we going to do? We are going to tag a few items, okay? Now, the way we're going to do this, we're going to go scoreboard players tag at a type equals item. That's a good start. So it's looking for every item. Now, what items do we want to do? We want to combine lapis and wool to create blue wool right here, okay? So we're going to add a tag. We're going to add lapis. And we're going to think, what kind of lapis, okay? So this is currently looking for every item in the world, and we don't want that. We need to specify an item. So we're going to go item, ID, Minecraft, colon, die. This syntax has to be absolutely 100% the same as what I'm doing, otherwise it will not work. Now we're going to go damage, 4S, which means just the kind of die it is. So we're still specifying. Count, 1B, how many there are. Close that off, and lastly, we're going to make sure it's on the ground by putting in that tag on ground 1B. Next up, we're going to hold down control, press our pick block button, and it's going to copy that command exactly, and then we're going to make this a chain command block, and because these are pointing into each other, this is going to activate only when this activates. Now we're going to make it conditional, so the command is only going to activate if this one activates. Cool. So now let's put in wool for this one, and this is going to have a damage of 0S. So it's only going to look for white wool, and we're going to add a tag of wool right there. Now we just need to summon the item, okay? So we're going to make another conditional command block where we execute at e tag equals lapis. Now if the wool is in the vicinity of that area, then it's going to do this. So execute at e tag equals wool, r equals 1. So if the lapis finds a wool block within a radius of 1, then it's going to execute the command. Otherwise, it's not going to do anything if they're not even close to each other. So now let's summon an item. Summon item at that position. We're going to make sure the type of item is correct. So we're going to go item, ID, Minecraft, wool, and we're going to make sure this wool has a damage of 11S. Now 11S means blue. Let's go count 1B and close our brackets off like so. But we're not quite done here because we need to kill the items. Okay, so that's why we're going to do this an easier way. We're going to give it a tag. Tags, kill item. You can call this tag whatever you want, and yes, the square brackets are necessary, just in case you want to add another one, like so. Okay, cool. Now, let's make sure we can kill the wool and the lapis. So now we go execute at e tag equals kill item. And we are going to kill at e tag equals wool within a radius of 1, conditional, and preferably c equals 1 as well, just to make sure that it only kills that, unless there's, just in case there's other wool within a radius of 1. Okay, so let's do the same thing, but with the lapis as well. Now we should be done. We combine these two. Let's just copy these, just in case this goes terribly wrong. And as you can see, it immediately turns into blue wool and kills both items. Like so. There we go. So, pretty cool. Floor crafting, you can craft anything you want on the floor now, which is great. Now, if you guys are still hungry for more custom crafting, let's say for more advanced players, you guys want to craft using a dropper. Well, that's going to be my next tutorial, so you guys can look forward to that. Thank you all very much for watching. Oh, and I need to do my recommendation, because I need to recommend YouTubers, because a lot of people have so few subscribers and deserve way more. So this recommendation goes to Coda. This is the last time I'm going to be recommending Coda for a while, because each YouTuber gets 3 recommendations. This is his 3rd, then I'm going to recommend another. So Coda is awesome because of his well-implemented concepts, I like to say, especially the ones where you pick up entities. That's just awesome, like puzzle maps, sci-fi kind of stuff. His concepts are really original, really cool. He has quite high standards for his video. So I highly suggest that you appreciate his efforts and go check him out and give him a sub. Tell him I sent you. Yeah, that's right. Thanks everyone for watching. I will see you guys in the next one. Take care.